Hello and welcome to Automation Step by Step. I'm Raghav and you are watching QnA Friday. And today I'm going to take up a very basic question asked by many of you, and that is, how do you find locators or identifiers for web elements on multiple browsers? So most of you might know that on Firefox browser, we have a plugin or an add-on called Firebug, which is very easy and very useful and very intuitive to use. However, we do not have the same plugin on other browsers, or I can say that this plugin works only on Firefox. So what are the other options we have on other browsers like Internet Explorer and Chrome? So today we are going to learn what is the very easy and very intuitive way of finding XPaths and other locators and validating your locators on these browsers. So let us learn that today.
Let us first go to Firefox, and on Firefox, the best plugin and add-on that we have is called Firebug. So search for Firebug and you will get this option to add Firebug add-on on your Firefox, and you can add it from here. And once you have it, you will have this Firebug option here. So let me go to any website, let us say google.com, and now you can see you will get this Firebug option here. You can click on this to activate the Firebug window and it will come like this, and you can also press F12 on your keyboard. You also have options to change the location of this window, so you can change the location from here. And now you can see there we have a pointer. You can select this and now you can go to your web page and select any element and it will highlight the XPath and other properties. So also you can see there is this Firepath option here, and we will get this after adding a Firepath add-on. So you can again go to your browser and search for Firepath and you can add this add-on. One thing to remember is Firepath is an add-on over Firebug. So first you have to get Firebug and then you can get Firepath. And once you have Firepath, you can have the options to generate absolute XPaths and other options. The good thing with Firebug is you can create your custom XPath. So for example, if I say here input, and now if I hit enter, you can see it has found 8 matching nodes. So you can create your custom XPaths and you can validate that your XPath is correct. So for example, I want to validate and find this search box. So I can see these are the properties, and let me just go inside and see. The name is Q, right? Here you can see the name property has the value Q. So if I want to generate some custom XPath, I can say input with name attribute equals Q. And if I hit enter, I can see one matching node. So my XPath is correct. And now I can use this XPath in my Selenium scripts. So this is how we can find locators in Firefox. Let us go to now Chrome browser. And on Chrome, we have the options to do a right click on any web element and go to inspect. So here you can see again, it has highlighted this information on the DOM and we can see the name is Q. But how to get the XPath? One of the options is you can go to this console, and here you can actually start typing an XPath and validate there whether your XPath is correct or not. So you can say $x and give brackets. And here you can start typing the XPath. So inside these quotes, I will say input where the name attributes equals Q. Now, if I hit enter, if it matches anything, it will show me the results. So as I press enter, you can see it has given me a result. So that means my XPath is correct and I'm getting one matching nodes, and also I will get all the properties here. So you can see all the properties I'm getting here. So if I expand it further, you can see all these attributes are here, and let us see the name is Q here, right? So this is how you can find it. But again, this is not a very intuitive and easy way. So what we have is in Chrome, we have some plugins available. So if you go to your app store, go to the web store, and here you will find a plugin by the name Eskry. So search for this Eskry and you will find this plugin. You can add it to your Chrome. I have already added it, so let me show you how does it work. So you can go to any website and then either press F12 on your keyboard or do a right click and go to inspect element. And now here you will have this option for Eskry. So go here, and now you can see you have two locators. One is XPath and another one is CSS selector. So you can select any one of these and then go to your website and do a right click on any element that you want to identify. And here it is asking to enter the name. So let me name it as search box and say OK. And now you can see you have got this search box and the UI identifier, which is an XPath. The good thing here is you get this test button. So you can click on here and you can see this is highlighted. And the another good thing is you can also customize this XPath. So for example, I want to write my own XPath and I want to see whether it is matching any element or not. So I will say input and I will say the attribute name equals Q, and I will again say test. So that means it is highlighting. So this is the correct one. Also, you can select the CSS selector, and now if you right click on any of the elements, you will get the CSS selector. So I will give it any name as search button and say OK. And now you can see it has given us a CSS selector for this button, and you can do a test, and again it is highlighting it. The another good thing is you can export this all these elements and their identifiers as a CSV or as a JSON. So I will export it as a CSV, and let me just show you. And now you can see we have got this CSV file with our two elements and their UI identifier. It also gave us the type and the matching node. So this is a very intuitive way for finding the XPaths and other CSS selectors on Chrome. There are some other plugins available for Chrome that you can use to find the XPaths and identifiers on Chrome. Let us now go to Internet Explorer. And here on Internet Explorer, we have some options, like you can again do a right click and go to inspect element. So here you also have this selector element. So you can click here and then you can select any element on this web page, and it will give you the on the DOM, it will highlight this. So you can again see we have this name equals Q and other properties. However, this is not again very intuitive or very easy. So what you can do on Internet Explorer is we have an option for getting this MRI tool. So this is the URL. Go to this URL and you will find this MRI test your selectors, and then you have to drag the MRI to your bookmarks bar. So you can go to your bookmarks. So my bookmarks are here, and you can also do a right click and say you should see the favorites bar here. So you can get the bookmarks bar here and then just drag and drop it to the bookmarks bar. So you will get it here. And now what you have to do is you can go to any website. So let us say I am going to google.com, and now you can click on this MRI and show all content. Click on this MRI, and now you can see it has given us this window. So it is saying us enter a selector and click MRI. MRI will highlight any element that matches the selector. So you can start typing here. So if I say input and I hit enter, you can see it has identified 8 elements and they are also highlighted on the web page. So if I want to select something particular, I can say at name equals Q, and now if I hit enter, you can see it is highlighting the search box. So let us test it on some other website. Let me go to WordPress login. Let me go to the MRI again, and I will start typing an XPath. I will say input and hit the enter button, and you can see it has highlighted all the input fields. So we have these two text boxes and this checkbox. So if I want to search something in particular, I can say I want to find all the elements which have type equals checkbox. So let me type this, and again I will hit enter. And now you can see it has highlighted only the checkbox that is available, and it is the single element. So one element selected by this selector. So this is how you can validate your XPaths and you can find the XPaths on Internet Explorer.
I hope you liked today's session. If you know more options to find locators and XPaths on multiple browsers, please write them down in the comment section. Also, if you have any query, any feedback, please write them down. If you have any queries or questions that you want to feature in the next episode of Q&A Friday, please send me your queries in the comment section or send me an email at ask.qnafriday@gmail.com. I will meet you in the next session. Thank you for watching.